Blackstone Audio presents Survival by Ben Bova. This book is read by Stefan Rudnicki. To Rick and Rich Wilbur, and all those tight games. The end is simply the beginning of a longer story. Zadie Smith. Book 1. I Am Become a Name. Prologue. Starship Sagan. It's obvious, said Vartan Gregorian, standing imperiously before the two others seated on the couch. I'm the best damned pilot in the history of the human race. Planting his fists on his hips, he struck a pose that was nothing less than preening. Half buried in the lounge's plush curved couch, Alexander Ignatiev bit back an impulse to laugh in the Armenian's face. But Nikki Deneuve, sitting next to him, gazed up at Gregorian with shining eyes. Breaking into a broad grin, Gregorian went on. This bucket is moving faster than any ship ever built, no? We've flown farther from Earth than anybody ever has, true? Nikki nodded eagerly as she responded. 20% of light speed and approaching 6 light-years. So? I'm the pilot of the fastest, highest-flying ship of all time, Gregorian exclaimed. That makes me the best flyer in the history of the human race, QED. Ignatiev shook his head at the conceited oaf, but he saw that Nikki was captivated by his posturing. Then it struck him. She loves him, and Gregorian is showing off for her. The ship's lounge was as relaxing and comfortable as human designers back on Earth could make it. It was arranged in a circular grouping of sumptuously appointed niches, each holding high curved banquettes that could seat up to half a dozen close friends in reasonable privacy. Ignatiev had left his quarters after suffering still another defeat at the hands of the computerized chess program and snuck down to the lounge in mid-afternoon hoping to find it empty. He needed a hideaway while the housekeeping robots cleaned his suite. Their busy, buzzing thoroughness drove him to distraction. It was impossible to concentrate on chess or anything else while the machines were dusting, laundering, straightening his rooms, restocking his auto kitchen and his bar, making the bed with crisply fresh linens. So he sought refuge in the lounge, only to find Gregorian and Deneuve already there, in a niche beneath a display screen that showed the starfields outside. Once, the sight of those stars scattered across the infinite void would have stirred Ignatiev's heart. But not anymore. Not since Sonya died. Sipping at the vodka that the serving robot had poured for him the instant he had stepped into the lounge, thanks to its face recognition program, Ignatiev couldn't help grousing, And who says you are the pilot, Vartan? I didn't see any designation for pilot in the mission's assignment roster. Gregorian was moderately handsome and rather tall, quite slim, with thick dark hair and laugh crinkles at the corners of his deep brown eyes. Ignatiev tended to think of people in terms of chess pieces, and he counted Gregorian as a prancing horse, all style and little substance. I am flight systems engineer, no? Gregorian countered. My assignment is to monitor the flight control program. That makes me the pilot. Nikki, still beaming at him, said,
If you're the pilot, Vartan, then I must be the navigator.
Astrogator, Ignatiev corrected bluntly. The daughter of a Quebecois mother and French-Moroccan father, Nicolette Deneuve had unfortunately inherited her father's stocky physique and her mother's sharp nose. Ignatiev thought her unlovely, and yet there was a charm to her, a gamine-like, wide-eyed innocence that beguiled Ignatiev's crusty old heart. She was a physicist, bright and conscientious, not an engineering monkey like the braggart Gregorian. Thus, it was a tragedy that she had been selected for this star mission. She finally turned away from Gregorian to say to Ignatiev,
It's good to see you, Professor Ignatiev. You've become something of a hermit these past few months.
He coughed and muttered, I've been busy on my research. The truth was he couldn't bear to be among these youngsters, couldn't stand the truth that they would one day return to Earth while he would be long dead. Alexander Alexandrovich Ignatiev,
by far the oldest man among the starship's crew, thought that Nikki could have been the daughter he'd never had. Daughter, he snapped at himself silently. Granddaughter, he corrected. Great-granddaughter, even. He was a dour astrophysicist approaching his 140th birthday. His short-cropped hair and neatly trimmed beard iron-gray, but his mind and body...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.